Hello guys, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is your host Francesco Alessio, back for another video. So today what I wanted to do with you guys is dive into the topic of Notion again. What I want to do specifically today is share how I manage clients and projects using Notion. I've talked a lot about Notion recently, but not really about how I use it. And sometimes people have messaged me saying, show us how you use something and that might help. And I am working on a little side project where you guys will soon get to share your own setups, which I think will help the extended community, because I don't really want to just show my setup. I want to show dozens of, you know, hundreds of setups, hopefully, in the long run, that will hopefully get you where you need to be. And you can steal bits from other people, which is great, which is fantastic, I think. So hopefully this video gives you a bit of context on how I use Notion for managing clients and tracking clients as well, using Notion. So I'm really excited about this one. Just before we dive in, guys, I want to thank this week's sponsor here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel, which is SetApp. Now, you've probably heard of SetApp before, mainly because they've already sponsored the podcast, the Tools They Use podcast on iTunes, and also this channel before, which is great to have them back because I'm a user of SetApp. I personally love their resource. And since I actually worked with them last on a sponsor, they've actually added a ton of new apps. So the essence of SetApp, if you've never heard of it, you basically can rent Mac apps instead of them buying them outright. And there are now 120 plus apps in that subscription, which is amazing. So you don't really get the stress of like one-off payments or even the download fees that come along with downloading apps on Mac, for example. 700,000 users have already tried SetApp, which is amazing. And I'm a user of it. I use it every single day. What I specifically love about it is whenever I need an application, I'll head up to the menu bar and search for a tool that I need, and I can download it there and then, as long as I'm on some good Wi-Fi. Now, SetApp is a $9.99 a month service available on Mac, and if you want to check it out, I'll include a link in the description, as well as my full review on SetApp too. They also have a Facebook group, so you can feel free to join that one, ask any questions you want about the service before you necessarily commit. Okay guys, let's dive into the topic of client tracking inside of Notion. Hopefully it gives you some good, tasty examples to go away with to apply to your own Notion account. So here we are with my Notion setup. Now obviously I'm going to do a full video on this very soon, because as you can see, it's probably dramatically changed the last time since you saw it. Just to be clear, I am using the lovely new dark mode. I think they've done a fantastic job on dark mode. Just a little tip, you can access it from up here. All you have to do is on the desktop version, that's all I know it for at the moment, is dark mode being accessible there. And you can use the shortcut Command Shift L if you're on Mac to toggle it on and off, which is quite impressive. Personally, I love it, and you'll be seeing my setup here today in that mode. So just to be clear, this video is going to give you an outline on why I use Notion for client tracking, how I use it, giving you an idea of how it sort of compares to the likes of Pipedrive, I guess, and hopefully give you an outline of how I use it generally for projects, because I guess if you guys are looking at it as a resource, then this might be an active example. Now, of course, I'm not going to show you my inside setup because that's quite personal, but I'm going to show you exactly the mock-up of it just without all the information on. Hope you understand that. Now, as you can see here, the real client page is over in my projects area. So it's the top of it. I access it quite regularly, so it's there for a reason, and I can go straight into it. Now, in this case, I believe I've saved the mockup one in other. Yep, mockups, clients. There we go. So hopefully this will give you a nice outline. So let's start off with the top element. I've kept the top simple, added the office emoji to the top, which you can do. Not really anything detailed here. So what I have to start with is a pinned, well, not pinned, it's just placed at the top, a page with my tax information. Obviously, being self-employed, you have to put your tax in and everything like that. I like this pin to the top because it means that I can check in exactly how much I paid so far. So I can actually go into that page and find all my payments so far in tax, which is quite helpful. And I can see all the projections as well, which is very easy to use. Now, just below here, I'll put the month. And this is almost like a just a baby dashboard before I enter all of the information. I've got my balance, which I normally put my current bank balance. And this is really ideal for freelancers because you can see a general idea of how much you've got in your current. And I've put a yellow sort of background on that just so it's like clear, like, okay, this is how much you've got to play with in terms of this month, next month's savings, etc. I've got my August goal, where I want the balance to be. So that's quite nice to see it below because I can go, okay, I'm going to target it there. And how much tax I have to pay left. And only recently have I sort of gotten to that interest in tax ideas. Obviously, the idea of paying tax and keeping it and tracking it inside of Notion. So normally what I'll have on this second segment here is goals area. So I'll put a nice big header, goals. And I normally lay out like three or four clear goals for the month of exactly what I want to do. So for example, this month for me is securing new clients and making sure that I can get some on board for the next month because I've dropped a few this month, this last month. So making sure that I have that is very, very helpful. So you can set out three or four. They're almost like objectives, I guess, to some extent, where at the end of the month, you can sit down and go, okay, did I achieve these? And they're actually weaved into my own goals section, which maybe I'll talk about in another video if that's something of interest. So in terms of structure, where is everything placed here? So I have a board which I used for clients, a board which I use for sponsors, and a board which I use for potential. And they're all regular boards, so you can add different views, but this is a really simplistic board. So as you can see here, I have a new client template. Whenever I wanted to make a new client or not make a new client, work with a new client, or I just want to get things done, I will duplicate that one and drag it onto the relevant area. And I'll just delete that for example. But it's just a good way to get started. So let me show you what a client template is for me right now. Again, I'm really trying to fine tune my stuff. And this actually isn't my latest version of it, but it will give you an idea of how I'm using it right now. So the new client template, up here I've got different areas or different tags, I guess, that you can highlight that help break down it. So for example, I have status, what's the current status of these, and that's actually the position in the board. The type of client, so I've got a few selected here, like is it a writing client, is it consultancy, is it one that I do screen sharing with as in like content creation, commission-based or a sponsor. Again, don't necessarily need a sponsor in that anymore. And also the payment number as well, which is quite handy if I'm working on a project only base, which can be quite helpful. So down here I have a basic template. So I have the current project, e.g. what I'm going to be working on with them. A lot of these clients are going to be like one-off clients. So they're working on a little bit of the project, or you know, they're not necessarily ongoing necessarily. You've also got notes down here, so you can start a list as well, and also the project outline. So what I can do here, and maybe need some modification on this, is exact dates and times that I need to check back in. This is generally a log that you can access, and the great thing is all you have to do when you're creating this is simply start adding this to the page. So this instantly becomes a page when you start adding it to the bottom. So you can see here, that's a new client template. When I get a new client, I'll add the information there, and I'll drag it to the relevant status area. So in the clients area, I have three core status sections. So I have active projects, which tend to be one-off projects or ones that I'm working on right now that I know I can see the end in, if that makes sense. Ongoing clients, which I know that bring the money in regularly per month, and I need to obviously like hygiene and keep up. Ending, so ones that I know will be closing soon, and I'll have all of that information there. And also ones that I've recently finished with, and that's just for reference there. So just to give an idea, if I go into this one here, client B, it will be in the ongoing status, obviously. The writing client this was, and I could also, here we go, I can add a few notes on the general proposal and what it is ongoing. So I can have all that information there. And this one here, for example, you know, like what is this article's, what articles have I done? What modifications have I done as a tally log? I really want to improve this in terms of the process I'm going through. But for now, it's a lot better in how I was using it before in Evernote. In Evernote, I was tending to just make a table, logging all of them and constantly adding to them. Again, I'm constantly refining this, and that's where I want to talk about Pipedrive near the end of this video to give you an outline on why I don't specifically use it yet. and why I use Notion instead. So they're the sort of four core areas that I use for clients. And obviously, as you guys know, we have sponsors like Set Up Today who come on the channel. And what I have is a separate area for that. And that's sort of like my two roles, my freelancing work and my creator work. And then I have the same sort of setup, upcoming ones, ones that are ending and ones that are recently finished as a way to view all of that. And I can basically just keep all the information there. Now, you're probably wondering, how do you capture like new leads or new projects that are coming in? That's quite easy. So what I'll do is, if there's any new leads that come in, like people that are interested in Francesco, could I borrow you for some influencer marketing or PR? And I'm like, okay, that sounds cool. Then I'll add them as an item down here as a potential in the potential table. And what I'll do is then, if the client goes, okay, we're actually looking at, you know, you for July time or August time or September time. This has obviously been refreshed since I last made the mock-up. Then I'll drag it to the relevant area. And as you can see here, maybe I've got a couple here that want me to contact them in August or the actual project starting in August. And all I simply do is, for example, if I'm like, okay, this one's starting and it's an active project, it's not an ongoing one, I will drag it up, whoop, to here, and be able to see that there. And then that's where I start adding really detailed notes. Again, it's a really simple process. There's not really too many intricate things about this. And what I quite like about Notion is that you can obviously drag it across different boards without it affecting the details inside or also the card itself. And finally here, I'll have a few previous clients which I'll routinely check in to see how they're doing, whether I can help them, whether I can just like see what they're doing, I guess, and just make sure they're okay, because I love to keep positive relationships best I can. So just sort of an outline of that. Obviously, I have the top, so I have clients, I have sponsors, I have potential, which I then used to drag up to clients and previous clients as well. I think it's a really simplistic process. There's nothing too much here. Many of you guys might know a software called KEEPPRODUCTIVE. This is more of a sales software. I know the likes of Paul Miners use it. He references it a lot. He also even does management training on it. But KEEPPRODUCTIVE is a lot more sales focused. And I think, if I'm honest, I probably will move to KEEPPRODUCTIVE in the next few years, but maybe I need to sort of get a bit more progressive. At the moment, this is a really healthy medium. So previously, I used the likes of Trello beforehand. So I used Evernote, then I used Trello. Trello was actually a good tool for it, but Notion, I feel like, is a really happy medium because I manage most of my projects here, and I would like to see all the information as well at a glance. So I probably will look to move to KEEPPRODUCTIVE. There are other solutions as well. I saw one the other day, HoneyBook, again, a one that you can manage proposals from start to finish. You can actually send them out. I don't think KEEPPRODUCTIVE does that. I think KEEPPRODUCTIVE solely focuses on the sales side of stuff. And another one called Talio, which was on, and I'll include these guys in links to as well, which is available on Product Hunt I saw on initially. So there are lots of different full client management solutions, but I think if you're getting started and you're sort of progressing, and I'm sort of in that stage, I'm like, okay, I've gone from Evernote to Trello to Notion in the space of 3 years, and Notion's something that I'm probably going to spend the next year with. So it's not like I'm leaving, at least from this side of the process. But obviously, you can create your own setup. So I probably need to do a bit more fine tuning with the template. So I'm talking your ears off now. Let me give you a few ideas of what I want for the future, at least in the next 6 months with this area. I'm going to create profiles for each client inside of their cards. I'm also going to have an area where previous clients are available to access sort of reference information, not their personal information or like client details and stuff like that, just what I've worked with them on, not necessarily the documents and stuff, just the general sort of agreements and information. So it's obviously going to be a place for that. So I'm going to have any current or upcoming work. I'm also going to add my ideal client list. So normally I have like this sort of list of 25 clients that I'd love to work with in the future as I progress my own freelance marketing work, and I can have that there. I'm also going to have a page for people that I work with specifically. So for example, the likes of Alice, who does the Tools I Use podcast scripting, and she does a couple of the website stuff, which is amazing. I'm going to have a reference area for that sort of stuff. So just to give you another idea of how I use this in the day. So what I'll do is I'll access the client's page probably once or twice a day. And what I'll do is I'll just check in and see if the page is okay. You know, general information, I guess, just routine admin. And what I'll do is if I have a new lead or a new client, I will do that automatically. Even in offline mode, it works very well. So for example, let's say, you know, Dave emails me and said, I want to work with you. I'll say, brilliant. I will add you, well, I won't say this to him in my own head. I'll say, I'll add it into Notion as a potential, and then I'll slowly manage that. So that's really easy. I'll just tend to start with going down in potential. Then once it becomes more date-based, I will move it onto different area into the month. And then once I'm happy that it's going ahead, I'll move it into active projects or ongoing, depending on the situation. Active projects, again, very static, more like a month or 2 months bit of work. Ongoing, more like 3+ months, just so I'm doing that. I'm always adding and removing new clients just so I'm always spring cleaning it. And what I'll do as well is at the end of the work week, normally on a Thursday or Friday morning, I will sit down. I will look at all my current clients and see areas that I can improve on all of them. Am I being fast enough with a lot of them? In terms of like response time, in terms of delivery of product, in terms of making and going above board a lot of the time. And then what I'll do is list a few ways and how to improve that. Or do I need to, dramatically do better? And that's when I'll highlight it inside of my Todoist as something that I need to focus on during the week. So I do have time to review clients and make it a bit more successful in terms of exactly how I can develop this. Now, of course, as I said, this is something open to interpretation, so I'd really love your thoughts in the comments below. If you've got any ideas on how you use boards very similar, maybe that would be something you can pop in the comments below, because I really love to hear stuff like that. Before we go, guys, a big thanks to Set App for today for sponsoring this video here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. You can check out my full review as well as the link in the description. And remember, they have 120 plus apps in their subscription. So if you're just starting out freelancing or something like that, it's going to be ideal for you. And another note, we're doing discounts now. Deals and discounts will be available in the description below. You can find discounts and even free codes for popular apps that are exclusive to the Keep Productive community available in the description below. And of course, you can access them anytime, and we keep them refreshed ongoing. So guys, I really appreciate you stopping by today. Hopefully this gave you some nice insights into my own Notion setup. And hopefully you can apply it to some of your own projects or activities. Or give me some tips and tricks. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers. I can't forget.